Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the bullpen. In the bullpen today, I have congressional candidate out of New Jersey, 9th Congressional District, Mr. Billy Prempeh is on the program. Billy, thank you for being here. Welcome to Indisputable.
Dr. Richey, thank you very much for having me. It's a pleasure.
Absolutely. Let me read a quote you made. We get right into it on this show, okay? Let me read a quote. You said, "We will never allow America to be overrun by the evils of communism and socialism. America will forever be free." I don't want to presume what you believe or know about socialism, but let's start there. What are your thoughts about socialism, and why do you consider it to be an evil in the United States of America?
Well, it absolutely, I mean, you don't have to look any further than Cuba. We see what's going on right now. They've been under dictatorial rule for well over 62 years. Prior to that, Cuba was doing quite well long before they got involved in communism. It sounds like a good idea at first. It always sounds good on paper when you say that we're going to have all of our collective means put together and controlled by the government. But at the end of the day, it always ends in chaos. The same thing happened in China. See how the CCP went from a capitalist system and they went to a communist system, and they even are now implementing some methods of capitalism to keep their economy up and afloat. But in these kinds of regimes, when the government controls the freedom of speech, the means of production, the economy, as well as the agriculture, it never ends well for the people of those nations. And this has happened historically throughout time. One of the largest killers of humanity is democide. It is the death of people by governments, and this tends to happen a lot in communist regimes, such as in Cambodia, North Korea, Cuba, and in the CCP Chinese and China as well too. Okay. So this is something that's happened historically throughout time, and it's not something that I ever want to see happening inside of the United States. I see a lot of people talking about consolidating power towards the government and pushing for some policies that sound good at first, but then they always end up in chaos.
Yeah, let me try to provide some nuance and a little bit of correction for you. You do understand that the number one government formation that has led to the death of more people than any other governmental formation is actually capitalism. You do know that statistically.
You said it has led to more formation?
All right. So what we're talking about when we talk about socialism, communism, capitalism, etc., we're talking about the formation of government. We agree on that, correct?
Correct.
The government formation that has led to the death of more individuals on the planet Earth is actually capitalism. As a matter of fact, you don't have to look no further. Well, you could challenge me. I will ask you to challenge me in just a minute. You don't have to look any further than what capitalism did for slavery, the enslaved in the United States of America. That was birthed out of the need of capitalism to always have a permanent underclass, to have a permanent labor underclass in order to support the competition that's required inside of a capitalistic regime. And it was also co-signed by governmental statute and policy in order to protect that enterprise of free labor. And so in order for capitalism to be all it can be, brother, it must always have a permanent underclass. And that underclass can be treated in ways that are completely adversarial to humanity and to ethical and moral behavior and standards. So we know that. But people are killed under the name of capitalism. Hold on, brother. Say that again.
No, I'm just trying to respond.
You're going to respond. And also the countless wars that have been launched in the name of capitalism as well, as it relates to oil reserves and embargoes and treaties and the like. All of these are elements of capitalistic fallout. But go ahead, make your point.
So the point that I want to make is, for one, I'm pretty sure you also realize that slavery has been around for hundreds of thousands of years. And this is not me condoning slavery at all. The United States no longer has slavery, thank God for that being eradicated in this country. In communist countries, for example, like China, they still have slaves. They still have people locked up in the Uyghur slave camps right now that are working on behalf of the CCP. Okay. Now, not only that, capitalism has brought more people out of poverty and has brought more people, has given people more of a better lifestyle of life than we've ever seen in human history. The slavery that you're referring to is like, I see how you kind of convoluted the two and tried to make it seem like that the only reason why capitalism is successful is because of slavery. There's many countries, as you know.
No, that's not what I said.
Well, you're
that's not what I said.
Never said that. I said you're kind of convoluting the two.
But I'm not.
Well, I mean, so there's lots of countries across the country. There's lots of countries across the planet that have never had slavery at all and have been able to prosper. Yeah,
but you're conflating, brother. I'm not conflating those two. Capitalism, even absent of slavery, is still a competitive economic formation of government.
Absolutely.
And absolutely. My point to you was about the death and degradation that capitalism has contributed. But let me ask you this, just very clearly. You do agree that every formation of government has had its mismanagement and corruption, correct?
Oh, absolutely.
Okay. Now, let's talk about Cuba, because you brought Cuba up. I have a limited time in the show. We'll get to Cuba and then we'll talk about why you think socialism is an evil. You talked about communism. That's a different formation of government than socialism. But we'll talk about Cuba. Cuba is a result of not only the insane policies of America, the schizophrenic nature of our embargo. Brother, just give me a moment. You get a chance to respond. Because of our policies that affected Cuba, President Obama said, we are going to try to equalize these relations because the embargo did not work. We wanted the embargo to have a goal. We wanted to reach a goal as a country. It didn't work. So he said, let's normalize these relations. Let's stabilize these relations. And you had some trade happening again. You had connection again. And then President Trump gets in. He reverses and then doubles down, makes it even more extreme on the embargo side. And now you have a contributing factor along with the mishandling of COVID, along with the mismanagement of resources, and along with the economic and jobs shortage in Cuba. You have to be thoughtful about enterprises like this, because government itself is not evil in itself. The government formation is not evil in itself. It's the individuals who are in charge. And that's the nuance I hope we can agree to at some point in this conversation.
No, I don't agree with you at all, honestly. I mean, are you implying that the socialism has worked in Cuba? Because there's lots of people.
Yes, I am implying that. So let me tell you where
socialism works in Cuba.
Brother, I'm going to answer your question, brother. I stand on mine. Socialism. Socialism is what you're living in right now. So you don't even realize
We have several socialist policies, but this is a capitalist nation. This is not. We are not living under socialism.
I'm going to let you finish, and I'll respond.
But I'm not going to let you sit here. I'm not going to let you sit here and say that.
Hold on, wait a minute. Hold on, brother. Don't get to tell me what you will let me do or not do, brother. First of all, if you don't want to be on the show and get these facts, that's on you. But no. you will sit here and listen to them, or you won't be on the program.
Working in Cuba, people are literally dying as we speak.
Yeah, I know that because of as I just said. Hold on, brother. Give me a second to respond to you, sir, if you're okay with the straightening. Because of mismanagement of resources, corruption in government. You scared of these facts. Mismanagement of resources, corruption in government. Yeah, people are dying in America. The hell are you saying about that? You're not saying a damn thing about that, right?
They're being killed directly by their government, my friend.
Okay, they are being killed by the government. Sir, listen to yourself. When a cop kills an unarmed black man, is that not the government?
Oh please! So we're gonna sit here and say that when the government goes out and kills someone unarmed, I'm not saying that this is something that's correct.
But you just said that doesn't happen in America.
No. But what I'm saying is that there's not people going door to door, rounding people up, pulling them out of the house.
Sir, those are evil and corrupt people, brother. My point to you is simple. Those are evil and corrupt people who disregard the humanity of others. I don't have any love. Listen. Listen, brother, I don't have any love for, I don't care what government you have, socialism, communism, capitalism. I have zero love for corrupt individuals in any position of authority. Now, are you able to say on this show, the people that are doing that in Cuba, they corrupt as hell, okay? They are corrupt as hell. Are the people doing it in America corrupt?
Absolutely.
All right, good, we can agree on that point.
Is the United States pushing policies that actively go after people? People that speak against the government. People that speak against the government. Where are they going? Name one person.
Let me,
government is going after, that speaks against the government.
Brother, I'm going to give it. You asked me a question, brother. Give me time to respond.
Go for it.
There's a young lady, 19 years old, a college student. She went to Utah. You need to research this story.
What's her name?
I don't remember her name. Producers will tell me in my ear in a minute. I did this story a few days ago, and I'll make sure you have the full context. And I posted it on YouTube. This young lady went to Utah, 19 years of age, college student. There was a back the blue sign, paper sign. Okay. She crumbled it up and she put it in the trash can. A deputy sheriff saw this action and arrested her for intimidating him because of this action. On the police report, he didn't cite that she did something else. He cited that she crumbled up the piece of paper in an aggressive fashion, gave him an intimidating look.
Lots of times, yes. I've seen this happen lots of times.
Let me finish. Let me finish.
Officer.
Okay, let me finish. Crumbled it up, and her name is Laura Garson, right? Gibson, excuse me. Laura Gibson.
Yeah.
Laura Gibson. Crumbled it up, gets taken to jail. The prosecutor gets involved and decides to enhance the charge and make it a hate crime, brother. This 19-year-old kid. Let me finish. 19-year-old kid has been charged with a hate crime for something that's not even illegal in most states in the United States, and it's also not illegal in a lot of the communist countries that you talk about.
So you literally just said that she tried to aggressively intimidate this officer. You're telling me that's
what? Wait a minute. So
you just said that she you're aggressively doing this.
That's a crime. Wait a minute, brother. Think about what you're saying. This right here. And me throwing it away. I don't care what the paper says. That's a crime to you?
Listen, no, if you're aggressively coming out, you're trying to make a
No. He says she aggressively crumpled up the paper. It's in the police report. That's a crime to you?
No, if you're trying to do this to an intimidating officer, yes, then you're trying to threaten this
what
officer.
What you mean trying to do? You cannot. Listen, brother. How can you? Listen, man, I can't believe you're running for Congress. Brother, listen to me.
I can't believe that you think socialism actually works in Cuba. People
Socialism, so I'm going to explain that, but you keep going around on the points. I'm going to explain where socialism works. You finished?
Go for it.
I'm going to explain to you where socialism works and where it does not work, number one. But right now, I'm explaining to you a point that you made that's incorrect. You said nobody in the government is rounding up individuals in America and putting them in jails. That is untrue. A young 19-year-old kid.
Against the governor, they're doing this en masse? Show me where. Show me where they're putting bullets in people's heads and throwing them in unmarked graves. Show me where they're doing.
Sir, those are corrupt people, sir.
I know, but I'm saying.
I'm bringing your attention. I have no love for them. I'm bringing your attention. Listen, man, we're going to have to be sensible. I'm showing you something now. If you would open your ears and listen.
About people, about rolling up paper and trying to compare that to people actually losing their lives.
Sir, the people in Cuba who are under this corrupt regime are good, decent people.
I agree.
They should not suffer as they are suffering. But I don't use the people of Cuba as a political point, brother.
I'm not using them
I'm telling you, you won't even let the sentence finish about the story of Miss Gibson, because you don't give a damn about what's happening in this country. All right, let's go ahead. Well, go ahead and listen to this. Do you think that crumpling up a sheet of paper that says back the blue and throwing it away should be a crime in America to go to jail for a hate crime? Do you believe that?
I'll answer that question with another question.
No, sir. Answer my question first, sir, and I will answer yours.
People go
be respectful of the format. Answer my question, brother, and I will answer whatever question you have.
That's what I'm doing. When people go and do this, when they're against Black Lives Matter, even gay pride, which I think it's ridiculous when people go out and do this, when people crumple up Black Lives Matter signs, tear them down, throw paint, and try and disrespect other people's freedom of speech and try and intimidate people, and I've seen this happen lots of times, all right? Would you consider that a hate crime if it was done to a gay person or to a Black person? Because we do see it all the time.
Now, let me do this. I'm going to answer that question, but obviously I'm going to have to teach you how to respect the format of the show. I posed a question to you first in all due respect. You have failed to answer my question, but you've posed one to me. I run away from no question.
So, brother,
my question is the same to you as it was a minute ago. Crumpling up a sheet of paper or a sign that says back the blue and throwing it away, should that be a crime, an offense in the United States of America against police?
A hate crime, yes. I would consider that a hate crime.
You would consider that a hate crime?
The same way that I would consider someone doing that to a homosexual or someone doing that to someone.
That's not the context of this story.
It's the same thing, bro. I consider it a hate crime, yes. It's literally the same concept, bro.
No, it's not the same concept. Yes. And I will explain to you where it's not the same concept.
I want to demonize cops.
Explain to you where it's not the same concept. You're just wrong. Gonna keep talking.
If somebody does that to a Black Lives Matter sign aggressively towards Black people, would you consider that a hate crime?
Let me explain to you the difference.
Would you consider it a hate crime?
Brother, you have still continued to bloviate. I want to answer the question. Listen, man. Brother, you've just posed the same question three times. Damn it, let me answer the question.
Go for it.
Thank you. I appreciate that so much.
Yes or no?
Anytime you have what's called an immutable quality, immutable qualities are what makes a hate crime a hate crime. Do you understand that terminology when I say that?
Immutable meaning like it can't be changed, yes.
Correct, it cannot be changed. So the things that cannot be changed, first of all, like this blackness, we're Black men. This will not change about us. It is considered to be an immutable quality. The fact that you have individuals who would target and do criminal activity to intimidate a particular race, that's considered a crime if you destroy property, if you destroy their property. So for example, the Black Lives Matter sign that was burned at the church, Asbury Church in DC. Remember that situation? The Proud Boys led that rally. They tore down the sign, they burned the sign. They weren't charged with a hate crime. There's no hate crime. They weren't charged with a hate crime. Now, that was criminal trespass, destruction of property because you could prove ownership, and the whole nine. So you literally had multiple crimes of trespass and property destruction that you can actually prove. In the case that I'm bringing to your attention, Ms. Gibson did not destroy the property of the police. It was a sign on the street that could not prove ownership.
But it's someone's.
So you're okay with the police locking you up for crumpling up paper? Just go ahead and say it, brother. That's what you're okay with.
If you're out there trying to intimidate police officers,
how the hell is that? First of all, you have a constitutional right to be a jerk. You can argue with a cop. You can curse a cop out. You can tell a cop to go to hell legally. You know that? Did you know that, brother? You have rights in this country. You have constitutional rights in this country. You have a right to be a jerk to a cop without penalty or prosecution. It's called the freedom of speech. You should try it.
No, you don't. You don't have the right.
You do have the right to be a jerk to a cop. What statute says you don't?
You have the right. It's common decency. If you're out here trying to. So if I came
at you. No, that is not a right, sir. That's some stuff you're making up. You have a right to freedom of speech in this country. Anytime the government, you need to go back and read the Constitution. Brother, anytime.
But if you're going, you have the right to freedom of speech, but if you're going out and you're destroying people's property, like you said.
No, sir, this was not charge them with destruction of property.
Say again?
Charge them with destruction of property.
I would agree with you on that, brother.
But that's not what they charged her with.
Well, you're telling me that he came at her aggressively.
No, sir.
That's what you started with.
The police report says she crumpled the paper aggressively. Brother, if you can't understand a simple sentence, good luck running for Congress.
I understand the sentence. You're kind of.
But I said it three times to you.
You're clearly anti-cop. You're clearly anti-police. And that's why.
Anti-bad cop.
Say again?
I'm anti-bad cop.
Well, it sounds like a pretty anti-cop to me, brother.
No, nope, I'm pro-good cop, anti-bad cop.
I'm pro good cop as well too, and I believe.
Are you anti-bad cop?
I'm 100% anti-bad cop. In fact, good.
At least we can agree on that. Now,
I actually have legislation in place to deal with these kinds of.
What legislation do you have in place?
Well, I'm looking to put forward what's called the Justice and Reporting Office.
So you don't have legislation in place.
Huh?
You don't have legislation in place.
Correction, I phrased it correctly. I have legislation that I want to propose. It's called the Justice and Accountability Reporting Officers Bill. It's on my website, BillyPrempeh.com.
Good. So you support the George Floyd Policing and Accountability Act then?
Say again?
You support the George Floyd Policing and Accountability Act?
No, I have a far better idea. You can find that on my website.
Okay, what don't you like about the George Floyd Policing and Accountability Act?
I believe that the George Floyd Policing and Accountability Act does a lot more to demonize police officers.
But what don't you like about the policy?
Say again?
What don't you like about the policy?
I don't like both. I don't like the entire bill.
Well, what part of it? You got a lot to choose from. What don't you like about it?
What I'm proposing is a chain of accountability and community cohesion with the people in the community. Not only this, and also I'm also looking to push
brother, listen. You don't get a steamroll beyond the question. You said you don't like the George Floyd Policing and Accountability Act. That's actually legislation in place, unlike what you said. You don't have a damn thing in place.
But removing qualified immunity is not a good idea, in my opinion. That harms officers. That makes it much harder for anybody to even want to be a police officer. I live in an inner city where this.
All right, so at least you have one issue with the policy. But if you're talking about creating a new policy that would allow for cohesion between community and cops and allow for a reporting accountability matrix, that's inside of the George Floyd Policing and Accountability Act as well.
I'm not gonna do it. BillyPrempeh.com, you can read more about it.
Okay, so in your proposed legislation, you do agree that police officers should be held to an accountability standard, correct? To a reporting standard.
I'm not just be held to a high accountability standard. I also believe that a new elected class needs to be created where community leaders that are elected by the people work hand in hand with the police officers.
All right. Let me read this to you because my producers are telling me I'm flat out of time. Socialism in America, K through 12 public education, Social Security, Medicare, single payer government run healthcare from Medicare, 65 and over, minimum wage. The child labor laws, all of these are socialist elements. All of them are in the United States of America. My ultimate point to you is this. Don't get caught up in calling everything evil because you would then have to call the other side always good. And the truth is.
Now you're painting me with a brush, you don't even know me.
Well, brother, you hold on, wait a minute. Did you not say, I didn't paint you with a brush. I read your statement. Your statement said, and I quote, "We will never allow America to be overrun by the evils of communism and socialism." Did you not say that?
I did, and I'm talking about communist government as a whole. The $15 minimum wage, that's one of the things I don't agree with. There's a lot of things that you just mentioned.
Right. We need to bring you back, brother. But man, do yourself a favor, brother, all right? Research the policies that you're talking about.
I think you and your viewers need to do yourself a favor and research what I'm looking to propose when I get to Congress as well.
You're not going to Congress.
Okay, that's fine if you believe that, brother. I'll see you on the other side.
You're not going to Congress. I appreciate you being on the show. Thank you, sir.
That's fine if you believe that, brother. Stop telling people that the Cubans are doing great under socialism because they're not.
No, they're not. The Cuban people are suffering. And they shouldn't be. And those corrupt leaders need to not be in power.
Cuba. You said it was working in Cuba.
No, I did not, sir. Socialism is not an evil in itself. What's my point?
Yes, it is. Yes, it is. Thanks for cutting me off.
All right. Have a good day, sir.
You too, brother. God bless you.
God bless you. Do you believe in white Jesus or black Jesus?
Why does that matter? I believe in Jesus.
All right. I thought so. Yeah. All right. Have a good day, brother. I appreciate you. Thank you, sir. I got to end the show, man. Thank you, brother.
Stop manipulating people.
You mad because I asked you about white Jesus or black Jesus? Come on, man. It does matter.
The problem with you.
All right. Brother, listen. Literally, I'm at the end of the show. So I got to go. All right. Sorry, man. You're acting like an ex-girlfriend, brother. I got to go.
Hang up.
All right. Have a good day.